Okay. The 7:30. We go. I see some Carmen ceiling. So cool. I really, my plan tonight, I actually messaged Kimberly last week and I was like, let's do a power hour. Like I need to refocus on kind of my own inviting and stuff. So she responded and said, great, you run it. So here you'll have it. So my kind of thoughts for tonight were really just to kind of touch base on some basics that kind of took me a while to grasp. And I know Teresa and I, you know, you and I have had this conversation a couple of times, and you hear the word like forming a lot, and form people and get to know them and then invite and all that kind of stuff. But I think sometimes I have to take it a step back and remind myself, like, what does forming really mean? And unless you've been to Danny Johnson or been on enough calls and heard it enough, sometimes it doesn't really sink in all the time. There you are. So I wanted to kind of take the first couple of minutes. My goal really is to keep this right at 30 tonight, but take the first couple of minutes and really just talk about what is forming and what does that really mean? Because you're going to have different markets, at least in my opinion, and Kimberly, jump in at any time. But I think you've got like warm markets, and then you've got kind of your mediocre markets, or maybe they're people you knew from like high school or old jobs or something, but you don't talk to regularly. And then you've got your cold markets, which is people that you've kind of either just friended or just met. And so I think you have a lot of different markets. Some people call it hot, warm, cold, or whatever you want to call it. But so there's different things. And so I think you have to always think about it differently when you're inviting people. To me, when I think about inviting, like when I first invited Teresa or talked to Lindsay about it, or even Bree, it was easy because I talked to y'all. Bree was even a little harder because we didn't talk all the time. But you kind of have to know where that person falls in your market. But I think if it's somebody that you're just maybe not as comfortable with, but you're friends with and you talk to, that's when those are the ones you have to really work on forming. Like your close friends, you don't have to form because you're going to know what's going on in their lives. But other people you do need to find out. And so the forming, the four things with forming is the F stands for family. The O is for occupation. The R is for recreation. And then the M is really kind of your message. And so the goal, what I always try to tell people is it's really three steps first, the F, O, and R, so four. And unless you know the four, like what's their goals? Like what's their four? What are they here for? Why are they talking to you? Why are you engaging in conversation with them? Then you really can't get to the message yet to form what's actually happening. So I always try to think of it as the four first and then the M last. And so I just start that way with people. Even if they reach out to me first about a challenge group and they say like, hey, what are you posting about? I will respond and say something very short and general, but I always end it with a question about like, well, what are your goals? What are you up to? Like, what's your family doing? Like, tell me something about you so that it's not constantly a conversation just about health and fitness and what am I doing? Because that way I feel like I'm really building that relationship and trust with somebody. So sometimes that takes longer. And that's where the patience piece comes in. And that's hard for me. Sometimes I'm like, oh, I feel like I've been having conversations forever. And while I'm enjoying getting to know people better, sometimes I'm like, am I missing the message? So that's the catch 22, I guess, also instead of 22, but you have to just kind of be aware of when is the right time to plug in that message. But if you go back to any calls where like Kimberly talks or Summer talks, you'll always hear that unless you've got, they have a need, then you're not ready for the message. So you've got to get to what's their need. Like what is their goal so that you even know what you're messaging them about. So that's kind of that. So my goal for tonight was really to spend the majority of this call getting our power hour done actively together. So when I was kind of looking through stuff, when Kimberly said, yeah, prep, I was like, I'm not a prepper. I'm a total last minute unorganized person. But so I did spend some time prepping. And I went kind of back through some prior calls and I was looking through and actually found some of my notes from when we did a power hour back in April. And I was like, wow, there's some people that I should probably reconnect with on there. So I really liked the way the power hours have worked in the past. I'm going to kind of stick with that same philosophy. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of just start with, I want you to spend the next, and we'll say, I'm going to give you 4 minutes to go to the most recent post you've had about, I usually say it's best to stick with something that's either going to be like health related. So like maybe one of your workouts or your shakes, or just anything that you've done recently. If it's about, you know, any post that you've had recently, like about one of the things that you're doing for your own development, whether it's your transformation, whatever that is, go to that post and write down every single person that liked that post and every single person that commented on that post. And then just take the next 3-4 minutes. Let's do that. I'm going to kind of play some music. We're going to come back and we're going to talk about how we're actually going to pick some people off that list and approach them. And I'm going to do it at the same time. So I haven't done my power hour today. So let's do that. Everybody go. Go to Facebook. Go to your posts. And I get to play music. Like a small town on the ocean, sending big waves and emotion. And I will say, once you've got everybody written down, come back into the chat and go ahead and write down at least 3 people that you'd want to message tonight. Yes, we're going to invite them now, Carmen. So we're going to spend a couple minutes there before we invite. So I don't know, as y'all kind of look through your list, and I don't know how many of you actually have done a power hour like this before, but like as I look through my list, and I'm kind of like, Carmen, there's definitely some people on here where, yeah, I've invited them before, or there's a couple where I've started the random conversations. I've done the 4. I've been in touch with them, actually even some this week and last week. And so the goal now is, when do you move it on to the next step? Like, what's that need? And that's where you got to kind of go through your list and know. So like Teresa, when you're looking at, you know, Amy, Karen, Macy, Jessica, and all them, what phase are you at with them? Where are you ready to invite? You haven't talked to you recently. Yeah. So I would start with the 4, the FOR. So if you're starting with them recently and they've liked your post, this is where you want to go into one. And if you haven't, I know we talk about it a lot, but if you haven't been into Everything with Heart and pulled the scripts, I highly recommend that. I heard that for months, and I would instead like write stuff down and then message Kimberly or post something in the group and be like, hey, how do I respond? Or I'd like, somebody else would post something and I'd be like, oh, that applies to me, and I would use it. But I actually finally printed a couple weeks ago the scripts, and I was like, hey, they're, you know, I should have printed this months ago. And they're actually really helpful. So yes, Teresa, my question or my answer to that would be is go back to the forming. Go back to that initial set on those people. And if it's somebody you haven't been talking to, those are the ones where you want to start off the script and say, hey, girl, how have you been? Thank you so much for liking my post. this is how I feel about my journey. I'm really enjoying what I'm doing. What have you been up to? And it can be that simple. This is not something where you're going to necessarily go in and say, hey, you want to join me in a group yet? Depending on what level you know that person, unless it's somebody you've talked to a lot. But if they're people you haven't talked to in a while, I personally, for my personality, recommend starting with that four, F, O, and R, trying to find out more about them and what their need is. That's okay, Bree. If you go into Team Courage's page, and Kimberly, tell me if I'm wrong. She's looking for the Everything with Heart. And if you click on their header in Team Courage, and then Kimberly, I think it says scripts up there, right? There's three links. I'm not in it right now. Let me see if I... let me get there, Bree, and I'll tell you, because that way you've got them. Or Kimberly, if you've got them up, go for me. So when you click on the header at the top, it'll actually pop up their links. And then there's one in there that says Everything with Heart. I mean, I can't really see my phone. But if you click their header, it's because it's dark in here.
Okay. Everythingwithheart.com, and the password is why not me, the number one. And then you have to hit submit. I think I wrote that wrong in the chat. No, don't press enter. Sorry. Not enter. And that'll take you into the website. And do you know what exactly it's over under? Is it just like coach resources, Leslie? Or you're saying that it's like...
I think it's actually called Challenge Group Script Training is the one okay. I did.
And there's so much information in there, and I agree, just print it out. But that's exactly what I'm saying. So, like, I went to a post, and I'm not even done. I went through, and this post has 46 likes. So I started to write down all the names, and if it was a coach, like we have 20 mutual friends, and they're all coaches. She's a coach, so I'm not going to write her. But I still got 22 names of people to write. And it's exactly that. Like a lot, it just depends on where you are in that conversation. If it's someone I haven't talked to like ever, or, you know, a new friend or something, I'll say exactly what you said, Leslie. I'm going to write them now and say, hey, it's my post, like my 16 days progress with like no weight loss with T25. But people love that because they're like not alone. So I'm going to say, thanks for liking my post. Like, it's hard to post stuff like that, but you know, we're all human and it's a hard journey. So I really appreciate your support. How have you been? Like, how's your summer been? That's it. Like, end with a question, like that they have to respond back with.
Yeah. And that's the one thing I'd say is always end with a question. And right now is a great time because people are going back to school. So when you're messaging people, say, hey, are you ready for school? Or, I mean, it can be anything like that. Carmen, as far as finding your last three posts, I can't do it on my phone, but I can do it on the computer. So for some reason on my phone, it only lets me go back to three also, but on my computer, if I minimize the chat and do it, then I can go back further. So it's also something you can just take and do after the call tonight. But to me, this is something that I've started doing pretty much at least weekly is I make this list again. And then if you're using Teamsy or if you're using a BAT system or spreadsheets, I know we all use different things. I'll just in Teamsy, I'll search the person and code that I'm sending that message. And that way I know when to set my follow-up or whatever your system is. Like, do that too, because that way you know who you're messaging and that way you don't miss the follow-up since the follow-up is so important. But so for the next 5 minutes, let's take three people that we just found off that list. And again, I don't care if you copy and paste, Amanda Pompa, it's not a voice message. But I don't care if you copy and paste the message. It can be that simple. It just needs to be something like, hey, girl, thanks for liking my post. I would say something personal about your journey. Like, for me, it's always something about, you know, I worked really hard for nutrition for a long time. I finally found something that is making me feel great. I appreciate the support, though, because it helps keep me on track. How have you been? Or are you ready for school to go back? And that's when you kind of go into that question. So for me, I kind of feel like if I personalize mine, it kind of builds up initial training or trust with them and then ask a question back to engage. Any questions on that before we break off to send? No, cool. Good deal. All right, so let's take 5 minutes and send at least three people. Oh, I was going to play y'all a song, but my playlist went away. In emotion. Teresa, this is for Barrett.
Yourself some friends or you'll be lonely once I was 7 years old. It was a big, big world, but we thought we were bigger. Pushing each other to the limits, we were learning quicker. By 11, smoking herb and drinking burning liquor. Never rich, so we were out to make that steady bigger. Once I was 11 years old, my daddy told me, go get yourself a wife or you'll be lonely. Once I was 11 years old. I always had that dream like my daddy before me. So I started writing songs, I started writing stories. Something about that.
All right, Lindsay. I want to throw out the first several I sent. My first power hour, I spent the whole 5 minutes debating what's right. Okay.
I was 10 years old. You see my goals. I don't believe in failure, cause I know the smallest voices they can make me major. I got my boys with me, at least I'm losing favor. And if we don't meet before I leave, I hope I see you later. 1,000 square meters on the story got cold. I was
all right, we've about 30 more seconds.
I'm still learning about life. My wife brought children for me, so I can sing them all my songs and I can tell stories. Most of my boys are with
me. All right. Yeah. Yeah, and that's good too, Bree. I mean, if you ever see people, that's definitely been some of mine. Like, I've seen people post some stuff about, like, my doctor says I have to do this and I don't know where to start. Anytime I see that, I definitely jump on those kind of posts. And I don't post on theirs. I go to private message and I take everything to private message and I'll ask them, like, hey, I saw your post. You know, I work with a group of people. We've been through so many different stories and journeys. And, you know, if you're looking for some support and accountability, I know my group could help you. What are your real goals? And like, I kind of take it back though to what are their real goals, not like what the doctor said or what they feel, and personalize it again. But yeah, definitely going with something like that. Yeah, perfect. You're always good at yours, Kimberly. You shouldn't get to post yours. No, that's
I just
great.
Want to show people it's not an invite. Like, when I'm doing that, it's not like to invite people. I go back to the forming. Like, that's forming for me. Like, how's your summer been? Thank you. What are you doing? Like, I'm just trying to start a conversation. And then that person is now on, like, this list that we just made together is now at the beginning of my planner in August. And I can go back to that list, and now I'm checking them as I'm marking them. Maybe the next step will be to highlight them and or put stars next to them. Like, I don't have a really great system as far as that goes, but whatever your system is, like, those people are going to be talked to like 2 to 3 times, or maybe one time I sit down and look at my list and I just go to Facebook and I comment on their last post, like what they're doing in their life. Like, I add value. I don't just look at people's posts. Don't just like people's posts. Comment on them. People pay attention to who's commenting on their stuff, not just liking it. They want to see who's paying attention to them. And people that pay attention to them, they want to pay attention back. They're going to go look at your page.
Well, and it makes them feel like you care about them, because you do. Like, your goal is to ultimately help the person. And so whether that be, you know, because they need help with losing weight, or maybe they are looking for more money and the coaching opportunity is a great opportunity for them. Whatever the opportunity is, yeah. I mean, engaging with them is just going to show that you care. And that's one thing I always do too. Like, if somebody changes their profile picture, I will immediately, if I see it, go and I'll like the picture. I'll write something under it, like gorgeous or beautiful or whatever. And then I'll immediately also go and private message them and say, I love your new profile picture. You look awesome. What have you been doing? Just start a conversation. Again, that leads me to a random conversation with somebody that I might not have ever started a conversation with.
Yeah, when people change their profile or their background picture, like, it's usually like a family picture, or they just got back from vacation, or they look or feel their best. Like, someone just had family photos done, and immediately comment on it, gorgeous, and write. I just did that today too, girl. Great advice. Like, I wrote them and I was like, who did your pictures? They look amazing. Like, what beach are you on? Like, talk about it. I want to know too.
Yeah. And half the time I really do. Like, I want to know, but, and it's awesome, but it, like, you take it offline with them private, and then you start to really build that relationship with them instead of doing it on their page. Cause if it's on their page, a lot of times it kind of gets to, like, that dead end point. Like, you can, like, message so much, you know, reply so many times before it kind of drags out. So,
that doesn't have to turn into an invite, guys. It's not like I'm going to invite those people that I just wrote from this list. Like, I just got to start the conversation. That's the patience part of it. Like, next week I'll go comment on their page. In 3 weeks, I might send an invite and be like, hey, girl, I know, like, or nothing, just like, my invites are so short and sweet, guys. You know that. Like, it's just like, hey, we have a group coming up to try out the new country heat. Like, what do you think about trying it out? Like, one of the names that I wrote down is, I did a country heat post, and these are the names that liked that. So my message to them will be like, hey, girl, I saw you liked my country heat video. Have you thought about trying it out? That will be my message. That is an invitation, people. That's an invitation. Either they've thought about it or they haven't. But they liked it. Why did they like it? It looked fun. They liked the music. They, Popples, like, do you want to try it out or not? Or I'm not, or then it will start a conversation. You know, the people that are going to be like, oh, I'm not coordinated to do that. Oh, yeah, you are. And that's the beauty of staying home, at working out at home. Then I'm like, oh, like, that's why I work out at home. Like, if anyone had seen me do Brazilian butt lift for 90 days, like, I would have been asked to leave the gym. Like, and true story, my coach who invited me, I was telling her that, I was like, there is no way that I would do this in front of people. And she said, true story, I got my husband to buy blinds for the living room when I started doing Brazilian butt lift.
Yeah, I had to edit part of my video the other day because John came in the room I was doing, he was like, what are you doing in my country heat one? And I was like, I don't know, babe, I'm tripping all over the living room. Like, Ian was doing it with me for a while. I mean, it was a mess, but yeah. So yeah, just start messages. Start messages with everybody, because it's amazing too how you will be messaging somebody and it will go nowhere with an invite. And then a month later, they'll post something else random and you'll start a conversation, and then they'll actually comment back that they've been watching you. And that's really kind of your ticket in to start inviting for different things. But Bree, some of this scripting stuff is great now, because now that you send some of these random messages, there's great stuff in here about when you get the blanket question about, I'm not really sure, how does this work? What does it cost? And how to not directly answer that. And what I am really good at is beach body vomiting and saying way too much information. So I've been really working on the scripts of keeping them short and sweet and then asking another question. And I still feel funny when people directly ask me how much the cost. I will still say something like, the cost is different based off program. I really want to make sure you get a program that you like and that works for you, because I would never want to set you up for something you don't like. Let's talk more about this first, because that way for me, I feel like I'm not avoiding their question, and I can still move on and go on. So, okay, we're running out of time. So the other thing I wanted to do that we're kind of running out of time for, so I'll just challenge y'all to do it tonight once we get off, is, and this one actually to me sometimes takes a little bit longer, but now go through your list and like go through your posts. And this may not just be like on your workout post. This is sometimes more when I'm just perusing Facebook. But look through some of your friends. Like, what are they doing? What are they posting? We all have some friend out there that's constantly posting motivational posts. Like Teresa, we have Trish all the time. I'm like, can you please just be a coach? Like, you're such coach material. You post positive every day. I think I've asked her like, I don't know, 4 or 5 times already. And I finally asked her again 2 weeks ago and I said, what are you doing? Why are you not coaching? She's not even on her Shakeology anymore because she had an injury, but she responded back and she actually said, you know, I've actually really been thinking about it. So she's in the sneak peek this week. I mean, we're making progress. I don't know that she'll sign up anytime soon, but those to me are the people that like we surround ourselves as this group because we're positive. And those are the people that we usually want to build our team with. And we've all got those friends who are constantly posting that, where you see them post something like Raquel last week, Lindsay, when she was talking about, this is my journey and I just hope this helps one other person. She's not a coach, but I'm like, why are you not a coach? Like, why not make money and help other people if you want to? Like, those are our ideal people. So that would be my next challenge once we get off, is to go through your friends list. Don't spend too much time perusing, because we have to stay intentional when we're actually working our power hours. But do keep in mind, and this is sometimes to me, like, I'm not even doing a power hour, but I'm actually just kind of scrolling Facebook while I'm waiting for my work computer to do something because it's slow. But yeah, you did get on the sneak peek. Way to go. And your message and Teresa's was really good a minute ago too. So, but yes, I will. Do I know how to create this interest list? No. Interest lists for people you want to invite?
It's not hard, Teresa. I can't like kind of give you the directions off the top of my tongue, but the fact that I've done it, I know that it's not hard. So, but If you Google it, it's an amazing website. Gary Vee told me to check it out. And how to do interest list on Facebook. It's really simple.
Yeah. And I can tell you too, though, my friends, when they post positive stuff, I always like their posts and I always comment on it. So guess what? They're popping up in my feed more anyways. Yeah. So, and I started messaging with those people anyways. And those are the ones, this is a quick invite. I will literally say, hey girl, what have you been up to? I absolutely love how positive you always are when you post. We need more of this in this world. You know, my great group of coaches that I work with, that's one of the things we strive for is personal development and being positive. Have you ever thought about doing what I do? Simple as that. I've complimented them on the what I like about them and what they're doing. I've given them a little bit of info on, hey Callie, on how it applies in our world, but not really telling too much. And then that kind of leads straight to that invite. And those are ones that I do direct invites on, just flat out straight ask people. So yeah. And ones people are kind of like, I don't have time, and you get a lot of objections, but those are ones you bring back to the group. And Kimberly's a wordsmith and can help us word through them. And the scripts are great. So use those. So I'm only 1 minute, but it was pretty good.
No, you did great. I am a big fan of interest list though, guys. And like, just you talking about this and like how I put it in my planner, like, I mean, I'm thinking in my head, like, why not have an interest list for like making my list of 30 to 60 names for a month and having them like in an interest group on Facebook where I focus on them that month. And then you set up, you get rid of that and then start a new group or revamp it for October, like September, and rename it, that sort of thing. So it makes it so much easier to just go to that and see who's like active and all that kind of stuff. So I set one up, or Blaine set one up for me, for all the coaches, and it makes it so much easier than for me to like think like, who do I need to go look at their stuff? You know what I mean? So
yeah. I always just like intentionally go to all y'all's pages and try to make sure.
And it takes a long time and I feel like I'm going to forget someone. So start it now, Leslie.
Good idea.
Of all of your coaches, or like have one that's, I have one that's PS coaches, and then I have one that's like all my downline, like extended coaches, to check in on. Like,
okay,
see what they're posting. Like, yeah. What you up to? So like Colleen. Hi, Colleen, if you watch this. But Colleen was in a car accident, which she didn't tell a lot of people about. But she was like radio silent on Facebook. I'm like, what's going on? You haven't posted in like 5 days. Like, this is not normal Beachbody coach behavior. And I found out she had been in a car. She's okay, but, you know, just kind of, it was bad. Anyways. You did a great job. Thank you, girl. I appreciate it.
Cool. That's all I had. So hopefully that helps. I know, like I said, for me, the first time I did a power hour, Lindsay, I literally sat there and was like, oh, I'm going to vomit. Who am I actually supposed to message? Like, okay, I'm writing this down, but I'm scared to hit send. But it becomes so much easier. And I don't know, for me, sometimes I do, I'll just sit at the house and I'll put my earphones in with the music, because I feel like if I'm in a good mood and I'm jamming, then I'm in a better mood and I'm probably going to send a more positive message. So I kind of focus on that stuff too, like whatever can put me in the right mindset and kind of get me going. Sometimes I do it at night when all the kids and stuff are in bed. So try not to do too much music then, because that wakes me up instead of winds me down. But you know, you got to do whatever works for your schedule and where you fit it in. Kind of like the 20 minute post you had the other day, wherever you fit your cracks in to make it work. So
yeah,
that's it. Not too bad. Over.
You did good. I will post the recording. I'll do it tonight.
Awesome. Y'all have a good night.
Bye, girls. Thank you.